Just remember, I was here before you, and I'll be here after you, make you running for you.
Eminem's surprise album Kamikaze generated nearly as many questions as it did units earned in its first week, as the monstrous 400K plus opener took aim at a variety of personas in the rap game today. And we are finally getting some answers as to why in a new sit-down interview with Sway.
When the Revival track list came down the pipe,
yeah, I remember that.
It was like, overwhelmingly, this is gonna be trash.
Yeah.
Let's start at the top with the fact Kamikaze came out of nowhere with absolutely no warning. Why was that the approach for the Detroit MC? I felt like the way the climate is right now, if you gave people enough time to say, man, he better have a song like this, or I ain't f***ing with it. If you don't have a song like this, I ain't f***ing with it. He better not be rapping like this. He better not be rapping about this, or I'm not gonna f*** with it. M went on to look back on his last album, Revival, and it admitted once the tracklist was released, it felt as if everyone had already made up their minds the project was going to be trash before ever hearing one song off the record. I remember a time in hip-hop when you had to be so different from the next people or you were trash. There's a shift somewhere that happened where if it doesn't sound like everything else, then it's trash automatically. M's reflection went beyond just 2017's Revival, but all the way back to 2009's Relapse, an album Marshall says he cringes at when hearing today, though he admits if he didn't go through that experience, he couldn't have come back and made Relapse, much like if he hadn't made Revival, he couldn't have put out Kamikaze.
I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny ass, let's talk about it.
And since the music world is still talking about Machine Gun Kelly's Rap Devil, M went into detail about what led to the cross-generational beef. According to Marshall, he came across a video of MGK talking about his daughter Haley a number of years ago on YouTube. Despite not being happy with what he heard from the Cleveland native, that wasn't even the reason he took issue with Kelly. The reason I dissed him is actually a lot more petty than that. Now I'm in this f***ing weird thing because I'm like, I've got to answer this mother f***. TBD if M cooks something up for MGK in response, but keep it locked to Billboard for the very latest. And until next time for Billboard News, I'm Kevin Kenny.